Wolf, we spoke to Michelle Hare a short time ago. She seems to be doing remarkably well given the news that she just got. She's caught up in the controversy over the names of the missing and the people who are they're trying to locate who have gone missing from this tornado. As an effort to streamline that process, officials today put out this list of 232 people who have definitely been reported missing by their loved ones. But in some cases, this list has led to more questions than answers.
For those searching for missing loved ones, accounts of heartbreak and frustration. It started with people like Michelle Hare, who couldn't find her 16-year-old son Lantz for days after the tornado.
Proper information is not being given to the public.
Complaints like that led officials to try to streamline the process. The Missouri Department of Public Safety is now in charge of locating those unaccounted for.
And we will provide today a list of 232 individuals that we have actual reports that individuals have come in and said that they were missing and unaccounted for.
But no sooner did we get that list than we noticed a problem in the case of Lantz Hare.
This is the car that Lantz was driving. His mother tells us it was on the other side of these train tracks, was picked up and thrown all the way over here where it landed. He has been reported by his mother as missing and was on this list of 232 people. However, there's a problem. It appears that his name's on the list twice. He goes by the name Kaylee Lantz Hare. Here it is listed as Kaylee Hare, 16 years old, 1601 Jefferson. On the next page, Kaylee Lantz, 1601 Jefferson, same age. We didn't get an immediate response from officials as to why his name appears on the list twice, but since we got this list, we were told by his mother she's had a positive identification of Lantz and that he is deceased.
Other families are complaining that they're not being allowed to go to a secretly located temporary morgue that's been set up, where the federal government has a team of forensic specialists helping to identify bodies.
Why not let people into the morgue to look at bodies and possibly identify them under your supervision? What's wrong with that?
Okay. The Disaster Federal Mortuary Team has several mechanisms to positively identify individuals. That is the most important thing. In a catastrophic event, we want to make sure that we don't make mistakes, that we positively identify these individuals. So fingerprints, DNA, medical records, whatever we need to do to positively identify so that those family members can get some solace.
A federal official told me a short time ago that another key reason why they're not letting people go into that morgue is that often in these situations, an accurate visual ID is not possible. He says that sometimes family members do make an incorrect identification, and that leads to more problems. Wolf?
And our deepest condolences to Michelle Hare and the entire family. What a horrible, terrible loss. Brian, we'll check back with you. Thank you.